our laboratory specializes in development of advanced concrete materials for future infrastructures, civil infrastructures that are more sustainable and more resilient to extreme loading. We envision that future infrastructures will be smarter than those that we use today, and we prepare and we develop materials to support that vision.
We are going to demonstrate impact test. We'll drop, in this case, 30 pounds of weight from a height of about 3 feet on a slab which is 1 foot by 1 foot. All we see at the bottom surface is these tiny micro cracks, which are going radially outwards from the point of impact. So as you can see, it completely demolished just in the first impact.
This characteristic is particularly useful for infrastructures that are subjected to extreme loading, such as earthquakes or blast loading. One of the challenges we experience in northern states in the US, like Michigan, is the severe winter, and that creates a lot of deterioration of our infrastructures, one of which most severe type of deterioration is corrosion of the rebar inside concrete. And when the steel bar corrodes, it expands and it causes fracturing of the brittle concrete. The ductility of high-strength, high-ductility concrete in that it eliminates this type of brittle fracture. Same kind of specimen, we corrode the rebar using an accelerated corrosion method, and you don't see that kind of disintegration of the concrete cover. The high-strength, high-ductility concrete is a new version of the bendable concrete in that it adds very high strength to the material in addition to the high ductility.
We'll do a bending test, so it's similar to a bridge deck being subjected to loads on top. It was a very sudden fracture. The bottom part is moving up, and each click that you hear is another crack developing. So if you focus on this edge, you can see these black lines vertical up, which signify a crack formation. So as you can see, it can bend up, but it's not failing or fracturing into two different pieces.
High ductility means that the material can withstand large deformation without breaking. It's emerging out into the real world, and it's applied to infrastructures like this building in the Tokyo area in Japan to withstand large earthquakes. We want both the built environment and the natural environment to coexist in a harmonious way. This type of material contributes to this goal.